Let's stand up. Let's have our faith.
Thank you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God and the Almighty Father.
May the Lord
Spirit, O Lord, sanctify these gifts laid upon your altar, just as he filled with his power in the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary, your Christ our Lord.
Amen.
During the Eucharistic prayer, those who usually stand, but if you need to sit, please feel welcome to be able to sit during the Eucharistic prayer. The Lord be with you.
And also with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so with angels, with archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we praise. We sing the hymn of your glory, as without end, we acclaim,
Holy, 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 Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with our bishops, Lionel and Terry. And we remember and pray for the Bishop of Rome, Pope Benedict, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. And I'd like to make a special remembrance of Sydney's friend, Corey, whose unfortunate passing we heard of. Welcome him and all the departed into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
And that was our custom. I would like to invite you to come around the altar to pray together with me the Lord's Prayer. As one family joined together in Christ with different approaches and many different things, but we are one in faith. We pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, protect us from all distress as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but look on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of our Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
As brothers and sisters in Christ, let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Thank you.